In this lecture, I am going to explain a new method to solve a linear programming problem, that is dual simplex method. Already in the previous lectures, I have discussed about simplex method to solve a linear programming problem. Simplex method is regular method which can be applied to solve any linear programming problem. So here the another method is dual simplex method. This is not a regular method. It has its restrictions. It is not applicable to any linear programming problem. It is applicable to certain set of linear programming problems. So this is not a general method. Even though it is not a general method, it has its own advantage. So we will see the advantage at the end of this algorithm. Okay. Right. So what is the main difference between regular simplex method and dual simplex method? So what we have done in regular simplex method? In regular simplex method, we start with a basic feasible solution, which is not an optimal solution, and we move towards optimality. We have started with a basic feasible solution and we verify the optimality condition. If optimality condition is not satisfied, then we find new basic feasible solution and so on. Finally, we reach optimality condition. Okay, that is the general approach in regular simplex method. But in dual simplex method, we start with a basic infeasible solution. This is the main difference. We start with a basic infeasible solution and works towards feasibility. Okay, so in the regular simplex method, we start with basic feasible solution and works towards optimality. Here in the dual simplex method, we start with a basic infeasible solution and works towards feasibility. That is the difference between these two methods. Right. Another difference. In regular simplex method, first we find entering basic variable and then we find leaving basic variable. Okay. But here reverse is done in dual simplex method. In dual simplex method, first we find leaving basic variable and then entering basic variable. Okay, that is another difference between regular simplex method and dual simplex method. This method is applicable only when all delta j greater than or equal to 0. Okay, this is a restriction for this method. So we can solve the linear programming problems for which all delta j greater than or equal to 0 at each step. Then only such type of problems can be solved by using this method. Okay, so this is main restriction in this method, but it has its advantage. We will discuss at the end of this algorithm. Okay, right. Now what are the steps involved in? In the first step, we convert the LPP into another standard form, that is dual simplex form. Not the standard form discussed in regular simplex method. What are the characteristics here? First one, convert the problem to maximization form if it is minimization. Okay, so this is same as in regular standard form. The objective function should be maximization. Next, convert greater than or equal type constraints, if any, to less than or equal type by multiplying such constraints by minus one. So here we have to convert all inequalities to less than or equal type. Suppose there is a constraint with greater than or equal, we have to convert it into less than or equal type by multiplying minus 1. So here we don't bother about the right hand side values of the constraints, whether they may be positive or they may be negative. So but in regular simplex method, we keep all the values on right hand side as non-negative. But here we don't bother about the sign of right hand side values. Okay, so the main point is we have to write all constraints as less than or equal type form. Okay, so two points: objective function should be maximization, all constraints should be less than or equal type. Okay, so after converting all inequalities as less than or equal type, so we convert these less than or equal type constraints to equality type. Since all are less than or equal type, we add slack variables to convert them into equality time. Okay. So this is first step. So we convert the problem to dual simplex form. That is, first one is object function is maximization. All constraints are less than or equal time. So we don't bother about the sign of right hand side values in the constraints. So once we get all less than or equal type constraints, we convert them to equality type by adding slack variables. Okay. Since all constraints are less than or equal type and we used slack variables, clearly the coefficient matrix contain unit matrix. Okay. So choose the variables corresponding to unit matrix as basic variables, that is slack variables, and find the initial basic solution. So here the solution is not feasible, just initial basic solution. Right. So as usual, in the regular simplex method, we calculate the initial basic solution, that is xb equal b inverse b. And for each variable, we calculate column vector capital xj. And for each variable, we calculate scalar delta j values as usual in regular simplex method. Okay. So after finding all those values and we put them in a tabular form as like regular simplex method, then we verify the optimality condition. Okay. So here all delta j greater than or equal 0. That means if this condition is satisfied, then only this method will be applied. Okay. So if all delta j greater than or equal 0 and all xbi greater than or equal 0. Xbi means basic variables. If all variables in the solution are greater than or equal 0, then the optimal condition is satisfied, then the present solution is an optimal solution. Okay. So here, this delta j greater than or equal 0 should be satisfied. Then only this method is applicable. Otherwise, we are not able to solve by using this method. Okay. So once we get positive values in the solution, then the optimal condition is reached. Then the present solution is an optimal solution. So otherwise means all delta j greater than or equal 0 and all xbi not greater than or equal 0. That means there are negative values in the solution. In that case, we have to improve the solution as usual by finding a new basic feasible. By finding a new basic solution. Okay. So here, how do you find new basic solution? So reverse process here. First we find leaving basic variable. Right? The next step. If all delta j greater than or equal 0 and at least one xbi less than 0, then go to next step. Step 4. If any delta j less than 0, then the method fails. Okay. So this method has the restriction, that is all delta j should be greater than or equal 0. If at least one delta j less than 0, then the method fails. Next step. So to find the new basic solution, first we find leaving basic variable. That is, in the solution, consider the negative values. Among the negative values, we consider minimum value. So find xbr equal minimum of xbi such that xbi less than 0. Then the corresponding basic variable xbr is leaving basic variable. Xbr is leaving basic variable and that corresponding row is called as pivot row. Right. If all entries in pivot row are greater than or equal 0, then the problem does not have a feasible solution. Okay. So in the pivot row, observe the entries. If all entries in pivot row are greater than or equal 0, then the problem does not have a feasible solution. That means the problem has infeasible solution. Then the process ends here. Okay. Right. Otherwise means if at least one entry in pivot row is less than 0, then it is possible to find next solution. So otherwise, right. In this case, we take the negative entries in pivot row, x, r, j. So here r is fixed row, rth row, j varies. So in pivot row, consider the negative entries. For that negative entries, we take the ratio corresponding with delta j value, that is delta j by xrj. Take the maximum of those ratios, that is delta k by xrk, equal to maximum of delta j by xrj such that xrj less than 0. Then the corresponding variable is entering basic variable, that is xk. This is kth column, so second suffix represent column. So kth column, that is the variable corresponding to kth column is xk. So xk is entering basic variable, and that column is called as pivot column. Okay. So here observe this. How do you find maximum ratios? In the pivot row, consider the negative entries. For those negative entries, take the ratio corresponding with its delta j value. Among those ratios, we consider maximum ratio. Then the variable corresponding to the maximum ratio is entering basic variable, and that column is called as pivot column. And the intersection of pivot row and pivot column are called as pivot element, as in regular simplex method. Okay. Find the next basic solution as in case of regular simplex method. We do the same calculations as in regular simplex method here also. Okay. So continue the process until either an optimal feasible solution is attained or there is an indication of non-existence of feasible solution. So we repeat the process until to get a feasible solution or there is an indication of existence of infeasible solution. Okay. So this is dual simplex method. Okay. So it is not a general method. It has its restriction. Now, what about the advantage of this method? So observe, if there is any greater than or equal constraint, we convert it into less than or equal type. Okay. So we need not use artificial variables here. So that is the advantage of this method. So right, see, advantage of dual simplex method. This method does not require any artificial variable. Hence, a lot of computation work will reduce. Okay. So if the constraints are greater than or equal type, we need not add artificial variables. So this is the advantage of this method.